heard and what our hearts have felt and for us, this community of faith and our friends and visitors who have gathered with us today from Youth Sundays. We thank you, God, for the love that we feel in this space. We thank you for our brothers and sisters. We thank you that we're all immigrants. We're all from someplace, but it is your love that brings us and binds us together. And so, God, we ask your blessings on this word as we speak forth the word of truth. We pray that the Holy Spirit will give us ears to hear and hearts to respond. It is in the name of Jesus Christ that we pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Well, you know, today is Youth Sunday, and usually the children are not in church with us, and so it is difficult for them to sit a long time and listen to a long message. So this is going to be a short message, so you have to pay attention and get it quick, because okay. I know the children's attention span is not very long, and most of us adults' attention span is not very long either. Amen?
Amen.
God bless you. Well, listen, the Huffington Post magazine printed a story a little while ago about three tiger cubs who were abandoned by their mother, and they found an unusual kind of love relationship with a white Swiss German Shepherd dog. The dog's name was Talim. So this tigress, she gave birth to these tiger cubs, and she simply walked away and refused to nurse them. So you know what that means, they have to be fed. And so the zoo officials at the zoo decided to see if they could find another mother who would nurse these tiger cubs. And so they looked around and they found a German Shepherd dog who was nursing her cubs, and they thought, well, maybe we could pair up these tiger cubs with the German Shepherd. When they first tried to do this, the tiger cubs splashed their claws and hissed and refused to nurse at the German Shepherd, with the German Shepherd. But what she did was amazing. The mother German Shepherd, with the tiger cubs hissing and clawing, simply lay down on her side and exposed herself to the cubs and waited for them to come to nurse. Eventually, one by one, those tiger cubs came up to the German Shepherd dog, and they began to latch on and to nurse. How is it that these odd and unnatural alliances can occur between species who are instinctively trained to be enemies of each other? How is it that tiger cubs can latch on and nurse with a German Shepherd dog? Well, animal behaviorist out of California, Jill Goldman, says that there has to be something in the relationship that has to be mutually beneficial for both species in order for them to get along with each other. Can you say amen?
Amen.
So this text that we read this morning in Matthew chapter 5, this is a continuation of the Sermon on the Mount that Jesus is speaking to the crowd that is gathered around him. He's sitting on the mount and he's teaching in chapters 5, 6, and 7. And Jesus sort of lets us sort of eavesdrop into what he's saying to his disciples. I found this text to be very demanding. How about you? And a little bit offensive to me. How about you? It was irritating to me to know that Jesus is asking me to do things that are so contrary to my nature and to human nature. He's asking us to turn the other cheek. He's asking us to not seek revenge when people do things to hurt us. He is asking us when someone sues you for your coat, take off your cloak and give that to them as well. He's asking us that if someone begs you or forces you even to walk a mile with them, we ought to go 2 miles. He says, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you. Well, it did, and I, for a while, I fasted the news because I just didn't want to hear it. Now, I was saying this morning as I looked at this text, Jesus, you cannot be serious. But friends, I want to tell you this morning, Jesus is very serious. And in this pericope this morning, our Savior is setting forth a set of values to which we as Christ's disciples, we who name the name of Christians, we must aspire to follow. They are seemingly impossible to do, and that is exactly the point. We cannot live this way. It is unnatural for us to forgive our enemies and to pray for those who despitefully use us. It is unnatural for us to do this, and we cannot do this without God's help. Amen? And a natural kind of love asks us to do things that are very contrary to our nature. Jesus starts out with his listeners and he said, you have probably heard that you ought to do this. But I am telling you, no. You have heard an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But I am saying, no, I want you to love your enemies and I want you to pray for those who use you. Jesus is taking his listeners back to the Levitical law that states that Israelites could only make proper restitution for a wrong done. In other words, if someone put out your eye, you could put out their eye, but not both of them. You had to leave them one eye. If someone slapped you with the back of their hand on one cheek, the Jewish of their actions. Okay, spoiler alert. For those of you that have seen Hidden Figures, I love the movie. I've seen it twice so far. Spoiler alert. You remember the scene where Octavia Spencer, who plays Dorothy Bond, goes into the library? You all remember? And she takes her two young sons into this library for whites only. And she takes them to the book section, and there are all the boys are sitting on the floor, and they're reading books, and Dorothy Bond is flipping through the catalogs and looking for a specific book about IBM machines. And then the books on the other side begin to part. And the lady, the librarian, says, what are you doing in here? What are you looking for? And she said, a book. And she said, but there are books in your section. And Dorothy Bond responds, but they don't have what I'm looking for. And the lady says, well, you know, you can't be in here. Then Dorothy Bond didn't get her dander up and start using a bunch of words that we cannot say from the pulpit on Sunday morning and tell her. And she just got a noise and we saw the was escorted out by the security guard, and they were on the bus on their way back home. And then Dorothy opens up her bag, and out of her bag comes a book. A book on how to program IBM machines. She took the book out of the library. Some call that stealing, but she called that active resistance. Amen? She later used that book to learn how to run the IBM machines, and later she and her girls, as she called them, became the programmers, and she later became the supervisor of that section of those IBM machines. injustice of that unfair treatment. We don't fight back, but we fight with active resistance. If we take an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth, then all of us will wind up blind and toothless. Amen? It is an unnatural kind of love that it does the unexpected. An unnatural kind of love does things that are totally unexpected. Jesus goes on to say, do not resist the evildoer. Give them your cloak. Turn the other cheek. Go the extra mile. Do the unexpected because it will throw them totally out of sin. Treat people with respect, even though they are disrespectful to you. Change the way we think. Change it to a way of thinking that magnifies and emphasizes the love of God. I know we have been taught that if somebody does something to us, we ought to get them back. Amen? If somebody says something about us, we ought to wrap it up, wrench it up, and say something even worse about them. The problem with repaying evil for evil is that it never ends. And if we repay evil for evil, I've said this many times, evil will never leave your house. It's like those dust balls under my bed from Colette, the cat. They just are always there. It's like a curse on your family. If you repay evil for evil, you'll never get rid of evil in your house. Phil and I were watching the news the other night, and we saw this wonderful special feature about the Iranian and American wrestlers. A beautiful piece. You all know that President Trump a couple of weeks ago froze the travel ban from certain countries. Amen? And one of those countries was Iran. And when he did that, he also prohibited the travel of Iranians to our country. And so the Iranians, they fired back and they said, well, if we can't come there, you can't come here. But nobody, thought about this wrestling tournament, this major tournament that's held in Iran every year for Olympic gold. Our American wrestlers go to Iran, and wrestling is very big over there, and so his ban almost stopped this tournament. Well, the good news is all of the stuff that happened since then, and the wrestlers were able to go, but it's what happened when they got there is what is so important. The two countries did not bicker, did not argue, did not hold grudges. They came together and they wrestled together. The Iranians won, but they shared a camaraderie in the sports arena. They didn't care about what the Trump administration was doing. All they cared about was their sport, and they were together, and it was beautiful. And it was wonderful to see them come together. They were supposed to be enemies of each other, but they called themselves friends. Saints, we must change the way we handle anger and bitterness and frustration and disagreements. We must ask God to help us to reflect God's love in all things, with all people. We must remember that even the people that we disagree with, even in our own church community, even in our families of origin, we are brothers and sisters together. We are in the family of God. We heard that this morning with our Black History moment, our acts of praise. We have one Father God, and we are all family together. And that natural kind of love asks us to do the unexpected, and that is to love each other. Amen. God asks us to be non-cooperative in the face of hate and brutality and injustice. But we are to do so in a way that is empowering, in a way that exhibits and magnifies love, as we saw in the kind of unnatural love in the life of Gandhi, in the life of the Reverend Dr. Martin Luther King, in the life of the great Nelson Mandela. in the life of Dorothy Hyde and Satima Clark, in the life of Rosa Parks and Fannie Lou Hamer. I think I know. I know animals get this. Animals get this unconditional, unnatural kind of love much better than we humans. We can ignore our dogs and our cats and our furry friends. We can show up late for feedings. We can not pet them and rub them and ignore them all day. But as soon as we get home, they are happy to see us and they greet us with tongue lips and purrs and shows of affection because they do not hold grudges. I think animals get this. A dog once nursed a baby squirrel as a part of her own litter. Captive apes once treated a cat like an infant ape and took care of it. And a dog once watched over a baby that was sick. We can learn a lot from animals. We can learn that instinctively, even though we might be programmed to be enemies and haters of each other, that we can take the high road, and we can learn to love each other, and we can amplify and exhibit the love of Jesus Christ that he said in this text today. Love your enemies. Pray for those who persecute you, so that you may be mature, even as your Father in heaven is mature. Amen.